Hi guys, it's Miss M, and this week I am coming to you live with a science video for a change, and we're going to be talking about a little bit about the different types of land biomes. Now last week you kind of read a little bit of a little information about the deciduous forests, and this week in science you're reading about the leftover five, but I figured I would tell you a little bit about each one. Some a little bit of information and show you exactly what each type of biome looks like. Now, the definition of a biome I kind of took from the book and kind of changed it around. It's basically a community of where plants and animals live in, and each biome has a specific type of climate, specific type of characteristics to it that makes it different from one from the other. A deciduous forest is very different from a taiga, which is very different from the tundra, which is very different from the grassland savannas, which is different than the desert and the rainforest. So I know this looks like a lot of information that I would like for you guys to copy down, but you can pause the video at any time so that way you can copy down exactly what I have written. So there are six different types of land biomes. As I said, a deciduous forest, a desert, rainforest, grassland, / savanna, because they're kind of the same thing a little bit, a taiga, and the tundra. So we're gonna start off with a deciduous forest, which is pretty well known in the United States. If you live in the United States like we do, we are a deciduous type of biome. The reason why is because we get all four seasons. That's the big thing. We get about 30 to 60 inches of water per year. And there's a rebirth, as I'm gonna call it, of trees and plants every spring. So that means trees that were alive in the fall and the winters are kind of dead or dying. And as springtime warms up and the temperature starts to get increased, new life is happening in the deciduous forest. And we have a pretty standard temperature. It's about 70 degrees, I would say, and I know in Florida we get a lot hotter, but throughout the whole country, it's pretty average temperature, around 70s, high 60s, low 70s, I would say. There is also, a deciduous is also called a temperature forest because it's very mild temperature. We go through different seasons with different temperatures. The United States is not also the only deciduous forests. There are deciduous forests in Canada and Europe and China and Japan and in Russia. And a cool fact about a deciduous forest is that we have very, very rich soil for plants and different types of new species of plants to be able to grow, which is really important. So here's some photos of a deciduous forest. Okay, as you can see, it's kind of changing seasons. We have some green from our summer, springtime, and we see some oranges and reds. That's probably telling us that this is turning into autumn or fall because the leaves are changing color, and that usually means that the leaves will start to fall down and starts the process of a deciduous forest in the winter, where you see it's very bare. The trees look very, very bare. There's no beautiful leaves. There's some leaves here, but they're pretty much, that plant is pretty much dead. Everything is covered in snow. So that's a deciduous forest in the wintertime. This is a deciduous forest, I would say, going into fall, maybe late summer, early fall, because there's still some greens, but you see all the different colors. And if you were walking around in a deciduous forest, you would see leaves everywhere. Now, the next type of biome is a desert. Now, deserts are very different because they have a very high and dry type of temperature throughout the day, really. So it's, think about Florida, but a little bit higher in the 100 degrees Fahrenheit area. And it's very dry and very hot, but at night, the temperature drops a lot and it gets very, very cold at night. And the reason that it's a desert is because it's very important to know that the deserts get less than 10 inches of rain a year. So in a deciduous, we get 30 to 60 inches of rain per year. In a desert, it's less than 10 inches. So there's very little life that kind of happens in a desert. You don't see a lot. You see some plants and some animals that have adapted to the desert lifestyle, but not many. And it's kind of barren, meaning that there's a lot of empty space before you kind of see some of these wildlife, some of these plants. And it's also important to know that not all the deserts are sandy. There are some deserts that have, you know, some different types of grasses and whatnot that you can see, but not all of them are sandy. So the most well-known ones are the Sahara Desert, which is in Africa, and the Arabian Desert, which is in the Middle East, and then there are some deserts in China. This is what a desert, this is the Sahara Desert. As you can see, it's a lot of sand. This one's pretty sandy, and you see camel, and there's a little plant, desert plant, right there. Now that desert plant is adapted to living in the desert, so it's not gonna get a lot of rain to grow, but underneath all that sand, it's probably very moist. The ground is very wet. That's what's keeping it alive. As you see some sand hills and sand dunes and all of that. So this is the Sahara Desert. And then this is an aerial view, which means it's an overshot of the Arabian Desert in the Middle East. So you can see this is all sand. All of this beigey tan stuff, that's all sand. So we can only imagine how sandy it really must look. It probably is very similar looking to the Sahara Desert, but I wanted to show you that this is from a space view, a big camera, to show you exactly what this could look, what this looks like. Now, our next biome is a rainforest, which is probably something that you guys are very familiar with. And our rainforests are usually located near the equator. Remember, the equator is that invisible line that separates the northern hemisphere from the southern hemisphere? So a lot of these rainforests are located near that. And it's got the name rainforest because it rains a lot, usually a couple times per day, and it's a good amount of rain. And because it's a good amount of rain, that means that the soil is fertile and really, really great to grow. And that's why all the plants are very, very vibrant in green color. Because of all that rain, the fertile soil is a great place to grow. And it's also home to many, many unique species of animals, including our sloths and different types of plants. We know only so many of these animals and plants because the rainforests are very thick, meaning that they are very deep and wide, and it takes a lot to explore. So there's probably a lot of animals and plants that we haven't even discovered yet. Okay, so you can find a rainforest in Africa, in Southwest Asia, and a lot of rainforests are in South America. And like I said, they get very hot and humid. Kind of like Florida, a little bit. So this is a picture of the bright greenery of the rainforest. As you can see, there's a lot of different plants going on. There's mosses all over the place. It's a very, very thick, as you can see, it's a lot of shrubbery, which means a lot of plants, a lot of trees, and it's covering a lot of area. And then we have another one. This is kind of a photo from above. As you can see, these plants and these trees grow very, very tall, very, very tall. So you can see from an aerial view, if we took a photo of it, you would just see a lot of green. And looking up, you would just see big, gigantic trees, home to many, many different types of animals. And, you know, you gotta be careful when you walk in a rainforest. So the next type of biome is the grasslands slash the savannas. Now those two are kind of similar, that you can call either one. The names are interchangeable. You can call it a grassland, you can call it savanna. And they are scattered. These are biomes that have scattered trees and plants and grasses. So it's not like a deciduous forest or a rainforest where everything is so right next to each other. It's scattered. So you have a few in one place, walk a little bit, there's some new plants and some new trees there. They have very long wet seasons, which means it rains for months, for a couple months, and then they have a dry season where they get a drought, which means it doesn't rain. So they could have six seasons of a wet season where it just rains constantly every single day for 6 months, and then it'll stop, and they could have a drought or a dry season for an additional 6 months. It's also very warm in the temperature. It's not as hot as the desert, but it's still pretty warm, but it's cool. The temperature does drop a little bit once that dry season starts, which is kind of interesting to think about. You would think that the long wet season would be cool in temperature and the dry season would be hot, but really it's the reversal. It's cooler in the dry season. And you can find these savannas. The largest one I'm sure you guys know is in Africa, but we can also find different types of savanna and grasslands in India and in South America and even in Northern Australia. So here's some photos. As you can see, you can look over there, you see some trees are not right next to each other. There's some that are, and some grasses, but it's kind of like bare land, some grasses. Then you got an area where there's a lot of shrubbery. Then you keep going and then there's a few trees. That's kind of what the savanna grassland looks like. And here's another example of it with some animals. As you can see, it's kind of barren a little bit. A lot of animals live in this area. Okay. And then our next season is called, our next biome, excuse me, is called the taiga. And the taiga is a foresty biome as well. It's one of the three forest biomes that we have. So we have the rainforest, the deciduous forest, and the taiga. It's a foresty type of biome. It has very cold temperatures, but it has very short summers. So these are places where the winter months will be longer than the summer months. Like we kind of talked a little bit about in Alaska. Alaska tends to have a long, long periods, or Canada even, long, long periods of winter and very, very short times of the summer. And you know, this is a biome that is known for our conifer, which you guys just learned, which is our cone trees, our pine trees. And you can find a lot of taigas across the world, especially in Russia. This is where the biggest amount of taigas are, but they're also found in, as I said, Alaska and Canada and Scandinavia, which is a little country near Canada. So those are really big places where you can find the taigas. So this is a taiga, I would say, during its summer months. As you can see, it's really pretty. Green trees, there's no snow on the ground. Nice place to be. And then a taiga during the winter months, it kind of is like the deciduous forest, except it's a lot more snow. As you can see, the conifer trees look a little bit more full. No one's looking dead like the deciduous forest has. And as you can see, this is a photo, I think, of wolves that are running by. And our last biome is the tundra. The tundra is known for having very frozen ground. You can't really dig into it because it's so frozen. It's usually an area with flat lands. Occasionally there might be some mountains up there. It has very little trees and grasses during the winter time, but during the summer months, the grasses and the trees do grow. Antarctica is the most well-known tundra because it's very flat. We know that it has some glaciers, some kind of ice mountains, and tundras are also far up in the Arctic Circle, which makes sense why Antarctica is up in there and why Antarctica is really our best well-known tundra. And as you can imagine, frozen grounds, it's gonna get very, very cold. I think it's negative 60 degrees or 30 degrees Fahrenheit. It's very, very, very cold. So this, I would say, is a tundra during its like springish, maybe summer times. You can see like a snow capping mountain. Here's some grass, a little moose. And some of the grasses I'll show you have a little bit of permafrost on it, which is frozen water that is found on grasses in early, early mornings. So it's a little ice cubey. And then here is a tundra during its winter times. As you can see, the white capped mountains. It's not very full of life, plant life, animal life at this moment. A lot of rock, a lot of this snow cap covering the grasses. If you try to dig into that, you're not going to get very far because that ground is very, very frozen. Some animals who burrow underground, they're able to get through this thick type of frozen ground, but not many. Okay, guys, so that was just a little recap, a little introduction to all of the biomes, what a biome is, and the six different types that you guys will be reading about. And you have read about the first one last week, but you still have to read these five. And I hopefully you will take some notes, learn a little bit more, and this will help you on Friday's activity. All right, until the next video. Bye, guys.